What if tigers were introduced into the African savannah? Seven big cats spread all over the world, dominating their habitats and able to all exist because they aren't all living in the same region. However, we're about to shake all of that up. We're going to be taking species of big cats and moving them into habitats they don't exist in, introducing them to the other big cat species and watching how things will unfold. Will it work out all right, or will there be absolute chaos? The big move we're making today is going to span thousands of miles, and we'll answer the question, what if tigers were introduced into the African savannah? African savannah. Let's first look at the eventual destination of the tigers that we will be moving. The African savannah. When many people think of the African savannah, they think of the wildlife, they think of big cats. Yes, there are many big cats that live here, but tigers are not one of those big cats. For starters, we mentioned that there are seven types of big cats in the world. There's dozens of feline species, but only seven that qualify as big cats. They are lions, jaguars, leopards, snow leopards, cheetahs, cougars, and of course, tigers. Many of these big cats have been spread out across the globe, making their existence easier, not having to contend with others too much. For instance, the Americas have jaguars and cougars. Asia has tigers, snow leopards, and leopards. And then Africa also has leopards, along with lions and cheetahs. This is a nice balance, a fair distribution of these powerful predators known as big cats. But the African savannah is one area that is already replete with predators, several of them being big cats. Any more big cats getting introduced here, and who knows what will happen. In addition to the lions, cheetahs, and leopards, other predators in the African savannah include hyenas, jackals, African wild dogs, and several types of birds of prey, like eagles and falcons. With the birds, there is always a pecking order. But as you can see, looking at some of these other predators, the African savannah has a pecking order with the rest of the predators too. You have jackals. Though vicious, they're usually between 20 and 30 pounds. African wild dogs range between 40 and 80 pounds. Leopards, cheetahs, and hyenas all range roughly between 50 and 150 pounds. Of course, there are always larger specimens of these species, but none of them will ever exceed 250 pounds. And then there is the lion, not king of the jungle, king of the savannah. Lions will typically be between 6 and 8 feet long and weigh between 350 and 500 pounds. It's quite clear who gets first dibs on meals in the African savannah. When these predators are looking for food, they'll turn to animals like wildebeest, zebras, buffalo, impalas, gazelles, and others. There are other animals which are not predators, but their massive size makes it fairly easy for them to not become prey, like rhinos, hippos, giraffes, and elephants. Although that's not to say they're never hunted, it happens. Now, when we're talking about the African savannah, it does cover a wide range of land on the continent of Africa. Because the savannas tend to be around 8 to 20 degrees away from the equator, they stay hot to warm all year round. They tend to not get any colder than 50 degrees Fahrenheit in the coldest months and at night, but typically, the temperatures stay between 65 degrees and 85 degrees. African savannas have wet seasons, but the dry seasons last much longer. These savannas can go for months without rain, causing there to be fewer trees than other habitats, much plant life that can thrive without water, and in many cases, extreme drought. So that is where we're going to move the tigers to. But where are they currently? Habitat of a tiger. Tigers live in many places, but none of those places are African savannas, nor are they anywhere in Africa. No, tigers are strictly found in Asia, but in many places in Asia. They actually are found in a variety of different habitats, from rainforests to temperate forests, from the constant heat in places near the equator to places far from the equator that experience the change of the four seasons. The range of tigers is impressive, one of the largest ranges in terms of any of the big cats. They live as far south as the equator, all the way up to 50 degrees north of the equator, making them highly adaptable. Most other big cats pick a specific habitat and live in a fairly tight temperature range, and get used to specific weather, but the tiger will take it all on. Tigers have been found to live in swampy areas and certain plains, but they much prefer forests as they like to blend in with the trees, especially when attempting to sneak up on their prey. They've been found at a variety of altitudes, from nearly sea level to as high as 11,000 feet in certain montane forests. Tigers have their preferences, but they will make it work wherever they have to, whether it be a forest in Russia that experiences winter, spring, summer, and fall, or if it is a rainforest in Indonesia with constant warmth and humidity. All about the tiger. So what does a tiger eat, considering it can be found in vastly different habitats? Well, they make do wherever they live, but they'll hunt for animals like wild boar, deer, water buffaloes, and pigs. If there are sheep, goats, and cattle nearby, they'll get those too. They've even been known to eat monkeys, elephant calves, and crocodiles. Their diet needs to be flexible to fit the areas they live in, but they prefer larger animals so that they can have one big meal all at once. That is often the case with large predators like the tiger. They're not always guaranteed a meal, so when they get one, they'd like for it to be a large amount to nourish them for a good deal of time. In fact, they'll often hunt and eat about once a week, and when they do eat, they might eat up to 75 pounds in one sitting. So if we've got a tiger that's taking down deer and water buffaloes and crocodiles and eating 75 pounds in one sitting, then he must be pretty big. Indeed, tigers are the largest of all the big cats in the world. They'll typically be between 8 and 10 feet long and will weigh between 500 to 700 pounds. They are extremely muscular felines, able to jump 18 to 20 feet and run up to 40 miles per hour. These are scary qualities of the already enormous cat if you are a deer or water buffalo in the area. Then again, tigers are ambush predators. They won't be keeping up those speeds of 40 miles per hour for long distances, so that's the only shot that its prey has to try to outlast the tiger. However, the tiger is smart and knows this. That is why the tiger uses its stripes to camouflage with its surroundings. It sneaks up on the prey, remaining undetected. The tiger gets as close as he possibly can, and then once the moment is right, he strikes. When the tiger pounces, he'll use his 4-inch long retractable claws that are sharp and curved to dig into his prey. Tigers are strong, able to lift twice their body weight. So if their prey thinks they might be able to escape the clutches of a tiger, think again. You'd have to be pretty big to win that battle. And their jaws are extremely powerful, one of the most powerful sets of jaws when it comes to big cats. They have a bite force of around 1,050 psi. So imagine you're the prey, and imagine a tiger's jaws coming down with that force, equivalent to the weight of a grand piano coming down on you, all while their 33-inch long teeth sink into you. This is no picnic for you, but this is exactly the kind of picnic that a tiger is looking for. And for these reasons, the tiger is the apex predator wherever he goes. China, Thailand, Russia, doesn't matter. The tiger is the apex predator in all the Asian countries he lives in. But what exactly is going to happen when we pick a few tigers up and drop them in the African savannah? Tiger relocation. We're picking up some tigers from Asia and shipping them off to the African savannah. The tigers are getting dropped down, let's say roughly 10 degrees north of the equator, right in the heart of Africa. It's 80 degrees. Tigers can deal with that. Many of them are used to that. It's dry. Some tigers live in dry climates, others in wet climates. No matter, this is the most adaptable big cat in the world. They'll make it work. There are trees, but many of them are spaced far apart. Not exactly preferable for the tigers. They prefer forests, plenty of tree cover. Now, that's not to say there isn't tree cover and that there aren't places to hide out, but it likely isn't like back home. Tigers are used to a thick tree line and a heavy canopy of trees overhead, and that just is not the case here. This is something the tiger will realize immediately. They're going to have to improve their hunting and stalking game. It's going to be harder to stay hidden and chase down prey. There will be less obstacles and plenty more opportunities for their prey to pick it up to a high speed and outrun the tiger. And every time a tiger doesn't have a successful kill, they've missed an opportunity to eat, they've expended energy, and there's less water around here. A tiger could get really thirsty out here. That could become a concern. But here are all the things that are not concerns for the tiger. There is plenty to eat out here. Just like the buffalo and deer they enjoy back home, there are buffalo here, and there are zebras and wildebeest and gazelles. There are plenty of hoofed animals to choose from. There may not be wild boars or pigs, but there are warthogs, close enough. And hey, tigers enjoyed going after the occasional elephant, calf, and crocodile back home. They can do that here too. Then again, when hunting for elephant calves, you must watch out for the defensive elephant parents. And elephants in Africa are far larger than the ones in Asia, so a tiger must tread carefully. Here is another pro to the move. The tiger is still the apex predator. He is bigger than the jackals and the African wild dogs and the cheetahs. He's seen leopards back home and they're here too. They're about the same size. No problem. And then there are the lions. The biggest predators before the tiger showed up. Not an animal to take lightly, but still an animal that is not as big as the tiger. An animal that the tiger is, on average, 2 feet longer than. An animal that the tiger is, on average, 200 pounds heavier than. The lion is a formidable opponent to the tiger, so the tiger will likely avoid battles when possible, but at least he can be confident in his size advantage if a battle were to need to take place. So the tiger can strut confidently along the African savannah, knowing he is the biggest predator here, and he can remain an apex predator. He'll be adapting to the climate and the terrain and the lack of trees, but he won't have to adapt to being the top dog. That will remain the same. However, his competition has probably increased. The lions and the hyenas and the cheetahs and the others, they'll all be competing for food. Then again, that could be a blessing. If a smaller predator gets a kill and a tiger happens upon it, he can scare away the smaller predator and steal some of the food himself. Maybe this won't be so bad for the tiger. He could thrive knowing that other predators could do the heavy lifting for him, allowing him to come in and get a free meal. We know that tigers are extremely adaptable animals, so we can be confident that the tiger will adapt in the African savannah. The tiger will remain confident in his status as apex predator. The hyenas and cheetahs and jackals and African wild dogs already were not apex predators, so another large predator is an inconvenience to them, but a minor one. However, it is the lions that will be most impacted, and they'll be very upset. They'll have lost their status as apex predator, their status of king of the savannah. It'll be a difficult adjustment period for the lion, as the tiger just stepped in and claimed the throne to the African savannah.